This is Rush to Reason.
You are going to shut your damn yapper and listen for a change, because I got you pegged, sweetheart. You want to take the easy way out because you're scared. And you're scared because if you try and fail, there's only you to blame. Let me break this down for you. Life is scary. Get used to it. There are no magical fixes.
With your host, John Rush.
My advice to you is to do what your parents did. Get a job, sir.
You haven't made everybody equal. You've made them the same, and there's a big difference.
Let me tell you why you're here. You're here because you know something. What you know you can't explain, but you feel it. You felt it your entire life, that there's something wrong with the world. You don't know what it is, but it's there. It is this feeling that has brought you to me.
Are you crazy?
Am I? Or am I so sane that you just blew your mind?
It's Rush to Reason, brought to you by Absolute Electrical Heating and Air, with your host, John Rush.
All right, hour two is upon us. Myself, Andy, Charlie Grimes, and we have a special guest joining us from Real Clear Investigations, John Murawski, who's been on with us before. So, John, welcome back. How are you, sir?
How are you? Thanks for having me on.
We appreciate it. Thank you for joining us. And so we've got 90, under the Biden administration, 90 federal agencies have pledged their commitment to equity with action plans that put gender and race at the center of their missions. What happened to the federal government just handling the things that we as citizens need and not going down paths that, frankly, don't matter at the end of the day?
Well, this is the new thing. You know, equity is the hot topic in academia, K-12 education, corporate workplaces, and the U.S. government and many state governments. So we're stuck with it for a while, and we're going to see what it does. But equity typically means trying to create circumstances and conditions that create equal outcomes for different groups, particularly racial and gender groups. So we're not talking about equal outcomes for Catholics versus Protestants or for tall people versus short people. It's the outcomes for the kinds of groups that matter in identity politics, which are generally race and gender. Primarily the group. So the policy, but what's interesting about this is the definition that's used by the Biden administration of equity is really a definition of equality, which means fair treatment for all groups, including rural Americans. And rural Americans is a code word for white people, just as urban Americans is often a code word for black people. Now, it doesn't necessarily have to mean just rural black white people. It could be black people, because they do have a program of a $4 billion debt relief program only for black farmers and other farmers of color, but not white farmers. And that got blocked by a federal judge. So those are rural Americans, too, and they're black. But generally speaking, their definition of equity isn't the definition you're going to find at Princeton or Yale or any of these private K-12 schools, which are very kind of woke definitions about oppression, microaggressions, identity, things like that. It's much more of a conventional definition of equality. But the policies in here are more in line with equity, which have to do with giving a boost and a leg up and helping out groups that are seen as marginalized or oppressed, to get them up, to give them sort of to help them get to catch up, essentially. It's kind of like affirmative action on steroids is really what equity is.
John, but, I mean, picking and choosing what groups you believe are marginalized and then forcing a leveling of outcomes, isn't that just legalized bigotry?
Well, these programs, I mean, so in the farmers, the lawsuit against the farmers, not the farmers, there was a lawsuit filed against the to block the program that was giving supposed to get $4 billion of aid to black farmers, and the judge that blocked it wrote that that using racial categories to exclude white farm to favor black farmers and exclude white farmers is, quote, abhorrent to the concept of equal protection.
Yeah.
Unquote. So these things are obviously controversial. And we really in this country have two competing definitions of fairness. One definition is get equal outcomes and make sure that everybody gets a prize. And the other one is make sure that everybody gets to play. Mm-hmm. And they're just two competing definitions. And as a journalist, you know, I'm not going to pick sides, but, you know, obviously it's obvious that the new definition of equity conflicts with the existing laws that we have on the books. And also with generally cultural norms that most Americans, including black people and Asian people, you know, like, for example, there's a lawsuit against Harvard and University of North Carolina, Chapel Hill, for putting caps on how many Asians you admit so that you can admit black people and you can get equal representation or balanced representation. Well, that, of course, harms Asians, and Asians are involved in litigation against that. So, yes, it's not – there are people of color who don't like it because they don't benefit from it either. They feel harmed as well. It's extremely controversial for obvious reasons.
John, you're not taking a side. I will. It's racism. It's bigotry. 100%. Not 99, but 100%. And, you know, proof – part of the proof is this. You're only doing it in select areas where groups that you decide are underprivileged – are the ones that are going to benefit. Okay, what about the NBA, the National Basketball Association? Are we going to put in quotas for hiring white players and putting them out on the court? Now, of course, I would be against that. I love all people equally, and I'm for everybody competing within whatever sphere they are, and let the outcomes be dictated by their excellence, not by the color of their skin. But when you only apply it in these areas, in these 90-plus equity plans, but you don't apply it in an area like I just mentioned, you're picking and choosing where to do it based on who benefits. It's racism.
Yeah, you know, it'll never happen in sports. And the reason it'll never happen
nor
in
should
sports,
it.
Because everybody knows that sports is 100% meritocratic. And people from the worst economic conditions can be some of the best athletes. So, however, there's even an exception in sports because we do have transgender females competing against regular females, I'll call them, like Leah Thomas, the swimmer in Pennsylvania, at the University of Pennsylvania. So you do have people who are born as males, they convert to or they transition to females, and then they compete against girls or women, and they are taller and stronger, and they have an advantage, generally speaking. So even there, you have that's a kind of equity. That's where equity leads. So it does affect sports in that way. So no, really, in a sense, even though I said earlier, you'll never have it in sports. There's really no domain of American life that would be untouched by this.
And let me be careful how I say this because I don't want to, for some odd reason, that we are all equal. We are equal under the law, but there is no way, John, that you and I, by the way, are equal. You have skills and do things that I can't do. I have skills and things that I do that you can't do. We are about as far from equal as it comes. Yet, John, we live in a society where we're trying to make everybody something they're not, which, again, is equal.
You know, the reason that happens is when there's, particularly among progressives, is a total loss of confidence of what the United States stands for or claims to represent. They believe it's been a grand deception to at the cost of women and gays and black people. And the only way to fix that is to rig the system in reverse until everybody catches up. So, you know, again, extremely controversial. I don't know that it's ever worked before. You know, the writer Thomas Sowell has written extensively about this and analyzed these kinds of programs around the globe. And they, according to him, they generally lead to ethnic conflict because you have the government that is, you know, essentially boosting mm-hmm. one group over another. But, you know, in a sense, you know, what it looks like if you're cynical about it, what it really looks like is what you're doing with equity programs is it just looks like old-fashioned politics. Like if you get elect us into power, we will redistribute benefits and privileges to you, our constituents. And that's just the way old-fashioned politics works. The people who elect you get special favors. And so it looks like old-fashioned politics. It's wrapped in the mantle of moralistic rhetoric. And you know, it just you're never going to get 100% agreement with these kinds of, you know, you're not going to get 50% agreement with these kinds of programs. They're always going to be controversial. So I don't know where it'll go. The equity action plans that these agencies put out, it's over 90 equity action plans that they released last month. And most of them are pretty vague. They use a lot, it's a lot of governmentese and bureaucratic language, but a few of them are particularly instructive. Like, for example, the most interesting one is the State Department. So they are looking to almost export American-style race and gender consciousness around the globe. And this is to, you know, a lot of countries are not going to be that eager to receive this American-style, we'll call it wokeness. And they want to do this as part of their diplomacy. So, for example, one of the things the State Department has already done, they've recruited 82 U.S. experts on diversity, equity, and inclusion to engage professional foreign audiences on a variety of topics, including awareness, identity, and activism. They've connected foreign journalists with U.S. experts on the history and the struggles of oppressed groups. They've had briefings of these journalists to teach them about Juneteenth, climate equity, the resiliency of black business communities, social justice movements. So, you know, it's a very it's an unusual topic for the U.S. government to be promoting as like here are the crown jewels of our civilization. And they are, presumably, they don't mention Black Lives Matter, but I assume they talk about Black Lives Matter and other of these kinds of movements. And the movements are quite controversial. I mean, these things are controversial in our own country, but they are aligned with the Democratic Party, and their Democratic Party is promoting them as, you know, American exports, essentially, now abroad. So, yeah, it's fascinating. I don't know how they're received in these countries, you know, maybe people want to hear all about all the problems that the United States has and all about the conflicts and how terrible things are. I don't know. But it is certainly an unusual approach for a State Department to take.
John, there are a lot of, you know, beliefs around the world that I certainly don't support. I mean, you know, like what China did to the Uyghurs and so forth. But where do we come off as America becoming the world's social preacher? Where is that our job? Were we christened this? I mean, how did we possibly get this role?
You know, where do we get this role? You know, the United States has, throughout the 20th century, been kind of a moral beacon around the globe. So we have millions of people who want to come here from around the world and live and enjoy the American way of life.
John, let me jump in for just a sec. Yeah. I want you to keep going. But we've been a moral beacon insofar as telling people not to kill people, telling people not to enslave people, telling people not to, you know, traffic in young women for sex and things like this. But this is different. This is telling people to choose which races to view in certain ways. That seems scary. That seems like a very new kind of way to be it.
Well, you know, all of this, you know, this equity and diversity and inclusion, people who advocate that see it as it's kind of like morality 201.
Yeah,
you know,
they do.
Equality, you know, true. Colorblindness and race neutrality from the civil rights era, that was morality 101. But now we're smarter than the civil rights leaders of the 60s. We now have critical race theory. We have queer. They were all homophobes. They were all misogynists. They didn't consider women equal. We're so much more advanced than they were. And that was, you know, 60 years ago. That's like in the dark ages. So there's this, I think, moral hubris that we stand on the shoulders of giants like Frederick Douglass and Thomas Jefferson and Martin Luther King Jr. And we feel that we're like pipsqueaks on the shoulders of giants, and we yet feel we're taller than they are, because we're standing on their shoulders. That's the only explanation I can give. It's a kind of moral hubris and a lack of historical context that gives people a sense. It's basically like children who think they're smarter than their parents.
Yeah.
Or teenagers. You know, I mean, that's the only explanation I can give. It's not really a sophisticated explanation.
No, good stuff. And no, we appreciate it. Real Clear Investigations, John Murawski. John, again, you're welcome anytime. I appreciate you joining us again, sir.
Thanks very much for having me on. I appreciate it.
You're very welcome. Good stuff. And I've got something I'm going to play when we come back that sort of dovetailed into all of this, by the way. So Veterans Windows and Doors is up next. And have them out and give you a education on windows and doors. Best way for me to say it. It's not a sales pitch. It's an education on what they can do for you, what you have going on right now, what needs replaced, what doesn't, how it's going to work, and so on. and they pride themselves not on just being veteran owned, but also giving you the fair price, telling you exactly how this works and what they're going to do through the install process as well. So don't fall for all the other gimmicks that are out there. Call Veteran Windows and Doors, 303-529-0720, or go to klzradio.com.
Veteran Windows and Doors proves that you can save people money while maintaining high standards. Owner Dave Bancroft believes product and service should stand alone. You shouldn't need to manipulate customers into spending more money. So when the company he worked for started hiring psychiatrists to train their sales staff, he left. Naming his own company after his military service, Veteran Windows and Doors, Dave chose to focus on quality rather than volume. He stands behind his product and service with a transferable lifetime warranty on all windows and doors, plus a 5-year guarantee on labor above and beyond the industry standard. Dave doesn't hire salespeople. Instead, he visits every customer personally to educate them on the product. Without the overhead of a giant sales team, Dave can offer the same high-quality windows and doors for a fraction of the price. No gimmicky pitches, no hiked-up prices, just quality windows and doors with service straight from Dave. Call Veteran Windows and Doors for a comparison quote now, 303-529-0720.
All right, up next, it's High Five Plumbing, where you can get your free water quality test. Just give them a call. It's really easy. 877-WE-HIGH-FIVE. Have them out. Do that test. Find out exactly what kind of water you're drinking on a daily basis. 877-WE-HIGH-FIVE or find them at klzradio.com.
Water is your number one enemy in your home. You need to solve the problem immediately so it doesn't get worse. You need a great plumber yesterday. High Five Plumbers believe you shouldn't have to clear your schedule or wait on a technician all day because they consider your time valuable. They bring all the right parts they need for the job so they can get it done right the first time they show up. With their GPS tracking system, you'll feel at ease knowing exactly how close your High Five Plumber actually is. You need to know what the problem is and how much it will cost. When they can't get out there in 12 to 24 hours, they can video call you to diagnose the problem remotely with High Five Live. Their coverage area is a little past Longmont and down to 6th Avenue. They also have a Littleton location that will service all the way out to Castle Rock. So schedule service with High Five Plumbing. Because you don't want a boring old handshake, you need a high five. Call 877-WE-HIGH-FIVE. That's 877-934-4445.
All right, folks, when it comes to real estate, we have your team, Catherine and Robin. They are from K&R Home Transitions. If you want two realtors for the price of one, just give them a call today and have them on your team. 720-437-8210 or find them at klzradio.com.
Catherine and Robin aren't afraid to get their hands dirty. Just ask to see their fingernails. Once you hire them as your real estate team, K&R Home Transitions aren't afraid to do the work no other realtor would do. If they need to, positioning your home to sell for a higher price. They roll up their sleeves and get to work. For one home foreclosure, Robin had to paint the fence outside while Catherine was painting the fireplace inside. You see, without their help, some of these homeowners would lose all their equity to the bank, walking away with nothing but damaged credit. Catherine and Robin even found a law firm willing to wait until after the sale to collect attorney fees because their client needed legal representation. The average real estate agent would never work this hard when you hire them. Call Catherine Pickering and Robin Lewis Oglesby of K&R Home Transitions now at 720-437-8210. Powered by Worth Clark Realty.
In the middle of the COVID-19 Wuhan virus reaction disruption, global elites announced the Great Reset. It's resulted in hyperinflation, war, and shortages. On the next Kim Munson Show, Dr. Victor Davis Hanson explains that we are about to see a reset of the Great Reset. Dr. James Lyons Weiler asks why the mainstream media is focusing on the distractions of the Roe v. Wade draft leak, Johnny Depp, and Amber Heard. Mortgage specialist Lauren Levy shares the latest on the Fed and interest rates. That's Wednesday, 6 to 8 a.m. with encores 1 to 2 p.m. and 10 to 11 p.m. right here on KLZ 560 and KLZ 100.7 FM.
Stay up to date on issues in public health and science by signing up and reading Dr. James Lyons Weiler's latest articles at Popular Rationalism on Substack. Find more information about Popular Rationalism at kimmunson.com.
putting reason into your afternoon drive. This is John Rush.
All right, we are back. Rush to Reason, Denver's Afternoon Rush. KLZ 560, myself, Andy Pate, Charlie Grimes. By the way, speaking of Johnny Depp.
Yes.
He was really the guy out there that really did need an Amber Alert.
Jeez. Oh, John. Seek help.
Hey, got a little humor in today somewhere.
It's good. I like it.
Somewhere, somehow, in the midst of all of what we have going on.
Yeah.
All right. So to follow up what we just talked about a moment ago with this agenda, by the way, that's out there. And it's not just in the federal government. It's in every form of government, I believe. It's out there. It is, in fact, an agenda. And I will preface this next little video that I'm going to play. This is Glenn Beck. And I like Glenn, although I will tell you that I don't agree with everything Glenn always says. Okay?
Okay.
I think I probably agree with over half of what he says, but I'm not a Glenn Beck fanboy by any stretch of the imagination. There's some things Glenn gets off on that I think are very conspiratorial at times, and that's, you guys know me, that's not me. I do respect him. I think he's solid on the majority of things he talks about, but... Richard actually sent me a little snippet of a video of Glenn the other day, and I wanted to play it because in this particular case, he's dead on. And it applies to a lot of the things we just talked about a moment ago.
Okay.
So rather than me say it, I will let him, and then Andy and I'll probably take a break and then come back and talk in depth about this particular topic. So let me play this.
Is happening by design. Tonight I want to show you the rainbow connections. And Kermit the Frog is not involved in this, although he probably gets some money from it. Do you remember when we were arguing back and forth about gay marriage? And I've had the same opinion on gay marriage, I think, my whole life. It's no business of the government. It's no business of
the
government. Anybody should be able to marry whoever they want. There shouldn't be anything that involves the government on that. But we didn't argue that. Instead, we got into some weird argument, and it ended up that love wins because Americans are compassionate people. But as we were standing here with our children, I know I've said for years, government has no place, and you can't base it on this, because that will open up a slippery slope. That, how dare you? This is about love. No, it's not. Yes, it is. No, it's not. Yes, it is. For the average person who is gay and wanted marriage, that's what it was about, but not the money. Notice what happened? Then anybody who made a wedding cake, you had to comply. If you took photographs, if you did flowers, you had to comply. Then the next thing was non-gender bathrooms. And I remember saying, how many people is this affecting at Target all over the country? Really? Then it was shout your abortion. Then Caitlyn Jenner, you had to say she was beautiful. Okay. Then non-gender started being talked about in school. It's not just the trans librarian that came somewhere up here. We started saying that there is no gender and that men can have babies. And then there was Leah Thomas. Everybody can be anything and compete. We've lost the difference between men and women. Now we're into serious sex education. I mean, not birds and bees stuff. I mean, actually... toys that should be nowhere around kids, K through 12. The only thing left now is man-boy love. Or what are they calling it? Adult-child attraction? That's coming. It's not about love. It is, and it always has been, about infanticide, abortion on demand at any time, no gender. Because that kills the traditional family, it kills the parents, and in the end, the target is the Western culture. I'm going to show you how this is all...
All right, I'll leave it at that. Can't disagree.
Well, yeah, I mean, he's simply describing the agenda.
Out. Yeah, can't disagree. And it goes back to this conversation we had a moment ago about these equity action plans. Fits right into what we're talking about there.
Yeah. It does.
It's exactly. We're just dovetailing into it. So, Glenn, spot on. You were right. We'll come back and continue to talk about that because, again, folks, at the end of the day, what we have to look at is, where is all of this headed? We always have to ask that question, why. And to Glenn's point, no, this isn't about equality. It's not about love. This is an agenda that's being pushed from the top down, force-fed, if you would, Andy. Not just pushed, but literally force-fed. You're going to believe it or else, Andy. That's what they say, right? You're going to believe it or else.
Well, yeah, and there is a real or else there because there are consequences. If you don't toe their line, your life can be affected.
That's right. Watch out. That's exactly right. We'll come back, talk more about that. Lines are open if you want to chime in on this particular topic. And I guess the question that I would have for you is, where does this stop? Where does this end? What happens to our country if we continue to go down this path? 303-477-5600. Affordable Interest Mortgage, folks, is next. And if you want to do anything at all with your mortgage or just get a mortgage review, it's as simple as that. Call 720-895-0500.
With rates on the rise, how do you get the best rate? Take AIM, Affordable Interest Mortgage, 720-895-0500. Did you know that when you get cash out or your FICO score is below a 740, or you're financing a condo versus a single-family home, it will cost you more in rate and fees? Many lenders are charging more. Stop paying it. At Affordable Interest Mortgage, we have lenders that don't charge. Trying to purchase a second home, or is your loan amount considered a high balance or jumbo? There they go again, charging you more. Take AIM, 720-895-0500. Let us show you a loan that doesn't charge more. Seeing a low rate but not reading the small print, only to realize all the extra costs and fees? Again, stop. Call 720-895-0500. Affordable Interest Mortgage. Quit paying fees and closing costs that are unnecessary. Get a low rate without all the extra cost. Let us show you how to save thousands. Call 720-895-0500 now. Affordable Interest Mortgage. 720-895-0500. Serving Coloradans for over 20 years. NMLS 298-191. Regulated by DORA.
Absolute Electrical Heating and Air, folks. That $49 AC tune-up, which we look out the window and, yeah, sunshine, and I know it's not super warm right now, 73 is all, but it's going to get warmer as we continue down the springtime path, which I believe is going to get warmer faster than what we would typically think it would, because we didn't really have any spring. We went from winter right into summer. Get that $49 AC tune-up special now. Call Absolute 720-526-0231.
You spend a lot of money on your furnace. Now make sure your investment pays off for years to come. Sign up for an Absolute Advantage membership to maintain your HVAC systems. Now free to KLZ listeners for the first year. Call 720-526-0231. The team at Absolute Electrical Heating and Air provides long-term customer service, meaning they don't focus on a one-time sale. They want to become your preferred home services partner for the lifetime of your furnace and beyond. To prove their commitment, they're offering free Absolute Advantage memberships to KLZ listeners for the first year, a $369 value. Receive waived dispatch fees during normal business hours, discounted after-hours service fees, a free yearly furnace maintenance and safety inspection, and more. Sign up for the Absolute Advantage membership now. Call 720-526-0231.
For quality and service beyond compare, call Absolute Electrical Heating and Air.
Group insurance analyst for all of your insurance needs, one-stop shopping, business, health, home, auto, all of your toys, you name it. They've got you covered. It's e-gia.com or 303-423-0162.
Finding insurance can be confusing, and picking the wrong plan can cost you thousands of dollars out of your pocket. You need an independent insurance broker to help you find the best coverage that fits your needs and at the very best premium. Call Paul Lenigro at GIA Insurance, and his team of independent insurance specialists will help you find the right plan for your needs. As independent brokers, GIA Insurance does not work for any insurance company. They can shop the market and find you the best premium for the coverage that you need. GIA never charges fees, and your premiums will never be any higher than going directly to the insurance companies or buying online. Receive the local, hands-on service you don't get with a call center or going online. Whether it is your home, auto, Medicare, life, ACA health, or business insurance, GIA has got you covered. They have been doing this as independent brokers since 1984. Call 303-423-0162, extension 100, or go online to e-gia.com.
Listen online, klzradio.com. Back to Rush to Reason.
All right, Rush to Reason, Denver's Afternoon Rush, KLZ 560. Myself, Andy Pate, Tito on the line now. Tito, welcome. What's going on, sir?
Hey, John, how are you?
Good,
hey,
sir.
Great discussion about this whole thing about equity and inclusion and minority and et cetera. But I think, and I want to get your perspective on this, I believe that this is really an attack not only on Western culture, but also an attack on every culture, regardless of their religion. Because I find it impossible to believe that people that believe Hindu or Muslim or whatever, they are, I find it hard to believe that they will be pro-abortion, you know, and want to get your perspective on that. And this is really an attack, I think, coordinated by the United Nations and other financial organizations around the world. Because even in other countries in South America, they have started to disseminate the message that safe and free abortions. So what's your take on that?
I don't know that I can disagree with you, Tito. I think this is an attack, of course. We know it's on our Western civilization because, again, they hate Western civilization. We're free. We know we're free. We perform business like we're free. I realize we don't have a total, free market, but it's still better than the majority of places around the world. So the bottom line, Tito, is, yeah, this is an attack on just the way of life that we here know. And I would agree with you. It's an attack on a lot of individuals' way of life, no matter what your background is, no matter where you've come from, no matter what your religious preference is. At the end of the day, it's an attack, period, just because you live here, Tito.
Yeah, and I believe some of these people, you know, of different cultures and religions, other than religion, they need to wake up and smell the coffee because they're basically these operatives in the United Nations. Really, we don't have any sovereignty anymore, just so you know. The United Nations really calls the shot, even in America.
Agree.
Today, I believe.
I agree with you on that, Tito. Let me rephrase that. When you have an administration like we have now, yes, you are correct. When we had the administration that we just had, which, by the way, a lot of Christians wouldn't vote for because he was just too doggone mean, Tito, and now that he's gone, you're right, the UN is in charge again.
Right. And that's what needs to be put into perspective. Some of these people that are supporting, you know, this particular administration agenda is saying, hey, wait a second, you know, you are going to be teaching my children, you know, that it's okay. And that needs to stop. So these people need to wake up and start smelling the coffee, I think.
I agree. No, Tito, you are spot on. I'll let you go. And I mean, folks, by what I said a moment ago, we've got folks out there, some probably even listening, that wouldn't vote for Orange Man Bad.
Right.
Because he's just Orange Man Bad. And yet Orange Man Bad ticked off the very people Tito was just talking about. In fact, threatened to pull all of our funding from said organization, if I remember right. Ticked off a lot of individuals, especially those that were on the left, because he basically thumbed his nose at the UN and said, you guys can go pound sand.
Right.
Right?
Yes. But
yet Christians, some of them hooty-tooty Christians, oh, I can't vote for him. He's just too offensive. He tweets out things that I just can't get behind. He's just so unchristian-like, I can't vote for him. Yeah, how do you like it now, folks?
Yeah, you know, that's just, I'm sorry, but evil triumphs when good does nothing. Okay, if you say, I just can't vote for him, I just can't. Okay, then everything that is done by the other guy who wins is on you.
It's your fault.
Because you stepped aside to allow that. You had a president here who, by the way, let's just really quick. Do we have a minute?
Yeah, well, yeah, go ahead. We're fine. Yeah.
Pre-COVID, he gave us a fantastic economy. We were rolling. Everything was great. There was no talk about, you know, having to adjust interest rates because of inflation and so forth. He also was a guy who was going to adapt quickly when things went bad. We wouldn't be dealing with this oil and gas crisis right now.
Nope.
And we wouldn't be dealing with a food crisis because he would have adjusted everything and said, okay, we're going to adapt to that. We're not adapting to anything right now. I could go through, you know, easily 10 issues.
Yeah, you know, the other thing that he would have done along those lines real quick, Andy, on the food side, he would have said, wait a minute, we export how much in food? We're feeding ourselves first. You guys can cut back your imports because we're not giving it to you, UN.
Yeah.
That's what he would have told them.
Yeah, and you know, and I do believe that he would have ramped up production.
Oh, I agree. I agree.
And the thing is that, guys, he loved the church. He loved Christianity, not in a way that put it above others, but in a way that stopped persecuting it. He secured our borders. We weren't under a constant, massive invasion wave. He did so many things. And you whine about the way he acts or about his past or about this. None of that affects you. You're not electing a minister. You're not electing your priest, okay? Sorry, newsflash, you're electing the better person to run the country. And right now, you stepped aside while somebody is now in the country smashing your rights to smithereens, who doesn't care anything about you. In fact, let's face facts. This guy who's in the White House right now is your enemy, folks.
Yeah.
He hates you.
Yeah.
He hates you, people in the church. He thinks you're a bunch of backward bigots. Mm-hmm. And you stepped aside for that because you couldn't stomach Trump.
I have too, Andy.
What a joke.
I have
you people are pathetic.
They are. I have absolutely had it. I'm exactly with you. You know my feelings on this. These are the individuals. You know, now, you know, movie 2000 Mules, was there definitely some hanky-panky that went on the last election?
Sure.
Absolutely. But if all of you individuals that we're talking about would have voted for Trump instead of what you did, we wouldn't be here, and you wouldn't have even needed that movie, by the way.
No. And by the way, I'm going to lump somebody else in with my Christian crowd, because there were members of my Christian crowd who did that, okay? But I'm going to lump in the libertarians. You stepped aside and cast your vote for a third party that couldn't possibly win, which means you did nothing. You mathematically did nothing. And the reason I'm bringing them up is a lot of my libertarian friends are the ones whining about what's being done to them right now.
Mm-hmm.
Well, what the hell did you expect? It's numbers, man. Don't tell me about your purity test. Don't tell me about your vote of conscience. I don't care. All that matters is numbers. Do we have more than them? Oh, we didn't? And you stepped aside? And you didn't contribute numbers? Now this is happening. So here's my message to all of them who didn't vote for Donald Trump. Shut up. You have no right to complain about what's happening to you right now because you stepped aside and allowed it.
Well, what you did was that slope that Glenn Beck talked about that I played for you all.
Yeah.
Donald Trump was the big boulder in that slope that didn't allow it to slide any farther.
Yes.
You rolled the boulder all the way down the hill by doing what you did and now allowing it to go all the way down to the bottom, right?
Very true. Very true.
Not that Donald Trump was moving things up because, by the way, once you get to a certain point on that slope, it's hard to go backwards. Gay marriage, by the way, is an example of that. Was Donald Trump going to come in and reverse that?
No,
absolutely not.
No.
Of course not. But could he put a stop to all of this other nonsense, transgender bathrooms? I firmly believe this as well, Andy. That if Donald Trump were still president today, this nonsense of letting a transgender individual win an NCAA swim match would not have happened either.
Gone. Let's do another one. Let's do one bigger before we get a break here. What about China? China infected the world, John. And I don't care how it happened. I believe it was created in a lab and let out. And all we know is then they stopped travel between their provinces, but allowed it to go outside their country. They infected the world. And what does Joe Biden come in and do? Because they own him. They gave money to his son. They own him. They own his family.
Sure they do.
They come in and he comes in and he rewards them. He pushes us and pushes us toward green energy, which is nothing but massive money for China because they've cornered the market on all the rare earth minerals you need for the batteries.
That's right.
And so what he's doing is taking the biggest, most prosperous market in the world, the United States market, and forcing it to buy Chinese products. Way to go, Joe.
No, let's not forget.
Give me a break. They infected the world.
There's so
many examples.
Donald
Trump said they should be paying trillions.
He did. Let's not forget one other big blunder that this current administration did that handed the Chinese trillions of dollars.
Afghanistan?
Thank you.
Yes.
Which Trump would not have done that way either, by the way.
No, he would not have done the pullout that way. He outlined how he would have done his pullout, and you would not have created this ridiculous vacuum. And now China, what do? They swoop in and grab the mines.
Right. So I'll ask all of you again, you Christians, and I know some of you listen to me because some of you I've known on a personal basis, so I know you listen. You listen just to kind of see what I'm going to say day to day and where am I at with certain things and so on. So I'm just going to ask the question, are you happy now? Did you get what you wanted? No more mean tweets, Andy.
Oh, boy.
Did they get what they wanted?
Yes.
Are they happier now than they were prior?
Well, no, they didn't get what they wanted. I'm saying yes, you did, because, hey, you stepped aside for it, so you might as well just say you wanted it. I mean, I don't want to hear them complain.
I don't either.
If you didn't vote for Donald Trump and ask others to do so, I don't want to hear you complain about one single solitary thing that's being done to you right now in this country. I don't want to hear it.
Oh, you lost your job. Oh, you're not selling as much in your business as you once were. Oh, you're not doing as well as a whatever as you once were. I'm sorry.
How many good Trump-supporting Trump voters? And you know me, I'm not the ultimate Trump guy. I want Ron DeSantis next time around. Right. That's who I want. But how many good Trump voters have lost their jobs, have lost all kinds of things, have had to move out of state, and had to change and have their lives go into total upheaval? We haven't even gotten into vaccine mandates. How many of them have had their lives ruined?
Right.
Okay. So if you didn't vote for him and you've had your lives ruined, all I can say is look at the people who did vote for him. You did this to them. Yep. I don't feel sorry for you.
Well, we'll go to break. We'll come back. We'll finish up Gino's Auto Services next, folks. Make sure that your vehicle is in, again, top working order. It's the best way to save money at the pump. I know I sound like a broken record there, but it is true. The better maintained your vehicle is, not only the longer it lasts, but the more money you save at the pump. 303-794-6700. Gino's Auto Service, and that's Gino's with a J.
Take advantage of Gino's European Car Special on your Audi, Volkswagen, or BMW. This month, save $30 on any repair or maintenance of $300 or more. For over 38 years, Gino's Auto Service has been serving customers along the Front Range. Gino's works on American, Asian, and European models. At Gino's, we are big believers in catching problems before they start. By following your manufacturer's recommended service dates, you will keep your car performing and get the most out of your vehicle. To make your life simpler, Gino's offers loaner vehicles so you can drop your car off and pick up when ready. Take advantage of Gino's European Car Special this month and save $30 on any repair or maintenance of $300 or more. We're AAA approved and located at Bowles and Platte Canyon. Stop in or visit us online at ginosautoservice.com. That's Gino's with a J.
All right, Al Smith, his Steps to Retirement class, they've got some going on this week. One was today, another one will be on Thursday, and then he's got another one next week. If you want to get signed up for that because you missed this week, you can still do that. KLZradio.com or call Al directly, 303-744-1128.
Your money market accounts aren't earning anything. Al Smith can provide optional strategies to protect you from market volatility while yielding strong returns. But first, he needs to find out what matters most to you. During a free consultation at his Littleton office, Al will listen carefully to your greatest concerns about retirement. He will make recommendations based on your unique circumstances. For example, some of Al's clients worry about the cost of long-term care. Once you establish your primary goals, Al will help you build a financial plan that will give you the confidence that your money will last. Al doesn't have his own agenda. He educates his clients, informing them about their options. Only after a thorough analysis will he give any specific advice. Call Golden Eagle Financial at 303-744-1128 for a free consultation with Al Smith. That's 303-744-1128. Advisory services offered through Foundations Investment Advisors, an SEC-registered investment advisor.
Folks, RanchFreshMeats.com, it's a place to help fight inflation. Greg Bloom has put a lot of good things up there to where you can fight inflation, get better quality products. His meat selection, meat, chicken, bison, pork, you name it, he's got it all. And again, he's put some things on the website to help you fight inflation. We're going to talk Friday, by the way, he's going to join me for Ready Radio. We're going to talk about preparedness and some of the things that he can sell you to help you in that area as well. So it's Barber's Foods. Go to RanchFreshMeats.com.
With the longer days and the warmer weather, I think most of us that have smokers or love to barbecue are already outside on the deck or patio grilling up and smoking up some good meat. But where do you get great quality meat sourced from ranchers that care about the welfare of the animals? RanchFreshMeats.com sells only the highest quality meat sourced from farm and ranch families that we know personally. For the month of May, we have a great special on Wagyu sirloin tri-tips from Dan Morgan's Wagyu Ranch. A Wagyu sirloin tri-tip roast weighs only about 2 pounds, but it packs one of the most flavorful beef eating experiences you'll ever have. If you've never had a Wagyu tri-tip before, you are in for a treat. Go to RanchFreshMeats.com and order your Wagyu sirloin tri-tip. And while you're there, check out their other monthly specials. And thank you for supporting a Colorado native farm family when you buy from Ranch Fresh Meats.
John Rush led his business through 4 recessions, and he wants to help you not only survive the recession, but also thrive. John helps you run your business smarter, not harder, by making sure your employees are using their time efficiently, planning for the future of your assets, and adjusting your prices to account for inflation. Do it better than your competition, because the alternative is going broke or out of business. Make a profit as a small business owner so you can rise above the rest. John Rush will help you thrive through the recession. Get a head start and get smarter. Email John at rushtoreason.com.
All right, Rush to Reason, Denver's Afternoon Rush, KLZ 560. Myself, Andy, and Charlie, we got another full hour, by the way, that we'll come back and talk more on this, because frankly, folks, this is where I really start to get ticked. Every single time I go and I buy either a gallon of gas or a gallon of diesel, I want to wring the neck of those individuals whom I know personally that wouldn't vote for Trump just because of their conscience.
What do you feel? How do you feel toward those people when you see good people being thrown out of our military for not getting a vaccine?
I guess I want to go ring. I guess these people, Andy, don't understand the battle that's in front of us. And I'm going to go one step further and probably step on more toes. You know who's really to blame in all of this?
Who?
The church.
Well, we didn't help.
No, you didn't help. In most cases, didn't do anything. In fact, in some cases, they probably encouraged because Donald Trump's if. Yeah, he is. Suck it up. Who cares?
He's not your priest.
No, he's not. He's not your best friend either.
No.
He's not dad.
No.
He's a guy you hired.
Yes.
Thank you.
He's an employee.
He works for you.
An employee. And what did you do? Because this employee couldn't be, I don't know, what did you want him to be, your Jesus?
Let me
explain out loud. Look at the employee you have now.
I know, but let me explain it this way real quick, just a comparison, because this is not the way the church will look at it. But here's how they should have.
Okay.
You're a bar owner.
Okay.
You like serving drinks and having order inside of your bar. So you hire Donald Trump to be your bouncer to make sure that law and order stays within what it's supposed to be inside of the premises of your bar. That's what you hired Donald Trump to do, right?
Yes.
Why can't anybody see that?
I have no idea. I have no idea. He's
the bouncer. So, yeah, he's going to be rude. He's going to be crude. He's going to say some things you don't like. But at the end of the day, will he make sure there's order? Yes, he will.
How many people have died because of the drugs pouring in through our southern border right
the fentanyl
now?
Huge.
Girls, how many youngs have been trafficked because of what's going on down there? How many terrorists have snuck in with the others because there's such a mob of people? I could go on and
more
on and on.
More than you'll ever know, Andy.
I can go on and on and on about all the horrible things that are happening to America and Americans, and you stepped aside and did nothing. Yep. Because, what, do you want to vote your conscience? Boy, I guess you left a lot out of your conscience. A lot.
How's that conscience working for you now, by the way? That would be the question I'd have to ask him. How's that conscience now?
Agreed.
Craig's up. Go ahead, Craig.
Hey, John and Andy.
Hey, Craig.
John, you hit a nerve. Ouch. I got home from work, decided to get my old style push reel mower, you know, non-battery,
yeah,
non-gasoline, because I paid, I don't know, another 15 cents a gallon today at the pump from just a few days
ago.
Yeah,
it's an all-time high.
Okay, while I'm out in my backyard, my neighbor, who voted for Biden and Harris because they had their yard signs, I can see his yard from my yard. I can see him out working on his sprinkler systems, and I just want to jump over the fence and wring his neck, just like you said.
Yep, yeah, because he's caused all this.
I have to drive 50 or 60, a little over 60 miles each way to work 4 days a week. So it is hitting me. Now, those that are working out of the home, they're not really too concerned about gas prices,
obviously. They don't care at all, Craig.
No, but, you know, I mean, they're seeing it at the grocery store, but, you know, as far as the gas, they don't care. And like you said, when you said that, it just hit a nerve with me. I'm like, I just want to jump the fence, because when you were saying that, I'm pointing. My wife and I are out on the back patio here. I finally got to sit down, and I'm pointing over at his house. I'm saying, that's just what John's talking about. I want to go over and wring his neck.
Yeah,
your wife has chained you to the ground, hasn't she?
To make sure that doesn't happen.
How far does that leash extend?
Hilarious. You know, we laugh and we have to, Craig, otherwise we'd cry. Bottom line is it's true. I mean, these are real emotions that at least some of us, I happen to have every time I go and spend more money on something that I really didn't need to in the first place if it hadn't been for a bunch of panty waste voting for Biden.
You know, I've got a 3-foot chain link fence in that direction, and I'm not as agile as I used to be. I don't know if I could hop over it, but there was a day I could just hop over that fence. That's not enough fence between me and my neighbor right now.
Raise it.
Good one. Got to run. Craig, thanks. I mean, not that I intended to strike a nerve with anyone, but this stuff should anger the majority of you. It really should make you mad. This is the repercussion. You know, elections have consequences. This is it, folks.
Yes.
We're there.
You didn't like Make America Great Again? Well, now we've got Make America Suck Again.
And
okay.
We're there.
How's that working for you?
For most, it's not, Andy.
No.
For most, it's not. So, all right, we'll be back. Another full hour coming your way. Lines are open. If you want to keep chiming in on that like Craig did, feel free to do so. 303-477-5600. By the way, the other side, it knows how to call to action. I'll talk about that as soon as we come back.
Okay.
All right. Hour 3 is next. Rush to Reason, Denver's Afternoon Rush, KLZ 560.